Now, Fluffy and Lamechop and I had been to the vet, and unfortunately Fluffy and Lamechop had hay fever and had to have a suppository for hay fever, and she was not well disposed to me or to the vet after that. She was a little stressed, and I thought she needed some R&R, so we thought we'd fall in this little Asian Chinese restaurant on the way home for some R&R. I thought I needed it, she needed it, and I think the vet probably did too. Yes. Anyway, so we called in there and I asked for a meat pie with dead horse and a sausage for Fluffy Lamechop with dead horse. And they assured me they didn't have any dead horses in the restaurant or in the kitchen or anywhere out the back. I said, well, that's not very bloody good, is it? I said, no, I'm sorry, sir, you can only have stir-fried chicken. What do you want to stir for? Just fry it, it'll do. With some rice and satay sauce. Oh, what a bloody satay sauce. Okay, well, I'll try this anyway. I gave some to Fluffy Lamechop because I thought it might quieten it down. Oh, dear God, she wolfed it down. She really wolfed it down. But then all of a sudden, she started complaining and wailing and yelling and screaming and, whoa, she was really upset. She really had a really bad stomach ache. And next thing, I said, oh, God, she's been poisoned by the stir fry. And next thing, this man next door to me on the table, I just thought, oh, he started yelling that he'd been poisoned. And other people in the restaurant started yelling that they'd been poisoned. Oh, Christ. And then this farmer sitting across the other table there was screaming something about, shut up that bloody feral demonic monster. Yeah. Well, I'm going to do something to take my cutlery to it. And poor old Fluffy Lamb. Oh, it's giving me a headache. This whole business, all this screaming and yelling and bellowing and things. Oh, Christ, about being poisoned and everything. It was giving me a terrible headache and really making Fluffy Lamb so upset. You know, the waitress came down, storming down, and she said, right. I tried to explain it. She told me to shut up and told the other man to stop screaming out about being poisoned. I told the farmer to shut up too. Which I think he wasn't very pleased about because he actually asked, did they have any, the lady, the waitress, did you have any tranquilizers, any earplugs? No, she sure she didn't. She said, what did you want them for? She said, I wanted you one of each of those two gentlemen. It's my husband and the man with the cat. And a tranquilizer for all three of them. The cat, my husband and him. So I can get some peace. But anyway, the waitress said that was a good idea, but she didn't have any of those things. So anyway, Fluffy Lamechop still getting upset. I said, well, I'll have to take it to the toilet. She said, you can't take a cat to the toilet. This is for humans. I said, but it's got to go. If it lets fly in here, God knows what might happen. Just imagine the smell. They'll think it's some sort of contamination or gas leak or some sort of pollution. You know, you'll have all emergency services here, the restaurant will be closed down, it'll be have to be decontaminated and all sorts of things. All right, take the thing to the toilet then. And of course, meantime, when I go to the toilet, the farmer, he's had enough. He asked his wife for the keys. He's gone off to the car to get his shotgun. He's going to take pot shots. He told his wife, apparently, that a bit of hot lead floating around the theatre would shut it up. I didn't think that he'd like that very much. I think that might make her even more upset. I don't think that would work at all. And she said, she told the waiters she wasn't coming back to the city anymore with her husband. It was just too stressful on her nerves. He just doesn't understand. You can't go down here taking pot shots of things you don't like, you can on the farm. Oh, God. Oh. And people started to run out of the restaurant now. Which I thought was really a bit much. I mean, just because the cat was complaining a little bit, poor Fluffy was complaining of her stomach ache. Anyway, so we decided to leave before the farmer came back. I didn't like all that hair parting material activity. So I thought we'd leave because two things. I didn't really like the food anyway, and they said some very nasty things about Fluffy Lamechop and me. They called her a grossly demonic monster, and me, a feral, demented despot. Whatever the hell that is, I don't know, but we're getting out of here, and I'll have to tell the vet not to come here too. All right. Okay. All right.